This is not a goodbye, despite appearances. It's a curious contradiction that quotes today in the house of God. Contradiction because goodbyes are usually sad. But we're celebrating here, today we are finished on a stage in our life. And celebration are often cause for joy. The world has these delusions. One thing may be another, and vice versa. A letter opener can be a dagger. A kiss can be a stab of love, or a love of lies. The world in which we move daily between reality and fantasy. The reality is that every day with its classes and exams. And fantasy is dreaming about the future that awaits us when we leave these institutions. And it is often difficult to choose reality when fantasy is much more bearable. This is not a goodbye. It should be a bye. A goodbye that will result in quote that compel us to turn to see in a few years. Thus, with a different perspective, which provides that the labor market very soon we will face. We might come to value fairly what we have assumed for years. There have been 11 long years that we have learned many concepts and theories, but above all, have helped shaping us critically to accompany all for our future actions, distinguishing ourselves above those who have walked other classrooms in other educational institutions. Only then will show that we have gone through an institution and not the institutions has happened for us. Very shortly we part. We will patiently and only a few remaining touch. That's life. It is impossible to get along with everyone, and it's also impossible to keep in touch when distance and professional obligation or personal disunite people forever. But this will not be a sad farewell, at least should not be, because today we are also in luck. In luck because today we celebrate that we are almost graduates. We still need a few days to get a diploma for which we have fought. So today we are in luck, because today we will do what we expect, get from the day we decide to join on this institution, hardly pronounceable name, First Baptist School. My classmates, you remember that when we were 5, they asked us what we want to be when we grew up. Our answers were things like astronaut, president, or in my case, a superhero. When we were 10, they asked again, and we answered rockstar, cowboy, Spider-Man, or in my case, gold medalist. But now when we grown up, they want the zero answers. Well, how about this? Who the hell knows? This is not the time to make a hard and fast decision. It's time to make mistakes. Take the wrong train, to get stuck somewhere, child, fall in love, a lot. Major in philosophy, because there is no way to make a career out of that. Change your mind and change it again, because nothing is permanent. So make as many mistakes as you can. That way, someday, when they ask again what we want to be, we won't have to guess. We will know.
En representación de los estudiantes del grado 10, se dirige a ustedes el estudiante Marcelino Hudson.
Este discurso nace del intento fallido de encontrar uno mejor en internet. Por eso tuve que tomarme la molestia de pensar en qué decir. Pensé primero en agradecerle a la promoción 2012 por todo lo que habían hecho, pero luego me di cuenta que me tomaría solo 2 renglones. Luego, una compañera me sugirió que les recomendara el uso de preservativos, pues la universidad es un criadero de enfermedades venéreas, y además que evitaran embarazarse. Me pareció buena idea, pero no quería al sexo como tópico central del discurso. pues los niños de sexto y séptimo seguramente se alborotarían. Y por último se me ocurrió hablar sobre esta ceremonia, sobre lo que se hace normalmente. Pero entonces tendría que decir que entramos bailando, recitamos papelitos aprendidos a última hora y simulamos estar interesados en esto. Mientras ustedes, querido público, nos miran desde sus asientos, en los cuales están obligatoriamente, nos critican, duermen un poco hasta que escuchan la voz del profe Germán, se vuelven a despertar y empiezan a criticar de nuevo. Por ser lo único que podrá sonar bonito. Esta ceremonia es la entrega de representaciones sensorialmente perceptibles de una realidad, en virtud de rasgos que se asocian con estas por una convención socialmente aceptada. Entrega de tiempo. Si bien todos sabemos que las banderas, el himno, la Biblia, el escudo y la llave representan algo, aún no le hemos dado un significado ni la importancia que merecen. Deberíamos amar al colegio y todo lo que se relaciona con él, pues es el espacio en el que nos hemos desarrollado no solo intelectualmente, sino también socialmente. Este es el espacio que ha ayudado a construir tu personalidad. Por lo tanto, parte de tu comportamiento se lo debes a este colegio. En ese orden de ideas, si el First Baptist School ha construido parte de tu forma de ser, ha construido parte de ti. Hoy estos símbolos los recibimos con amor, pues son parte de nosotros y también parte de ustedes. Gracias.
Ok, ahora sí, para finalizar, invitamos a nuestro señor rector, el pastor Ricardo Bordomé, a que nos dirija una pequeña palabra. Un aplauso para él, por favor.
To remember the foundation that move us and keep us going. If we ask the question, what makes a person? What it takes to make a person? And if we try to answer that question, we're going to find that it takes a lot of things. It takes a home, some parents. It takes a community, but not all. It takes a school. Wherever we have people, you will always find a school. Because a school is an essential part of making us who we are. Students of 11th grade, you have gone through our institution, and we have given our input into your life. We are not the only ones, but no doubt we have done a very important role in making you who you are today. You are leaving, and as you leave, what we place in you is what you are going to use to be who you want to be. Of course, your process has not finished. You still have a lot more to go. And as you leave from here and you go to work or you go to the university, other institutions will give their input, other people, other culture that you will come in contact with also will give their input into who you are going to be. But I'm sure that First Baptist School, input of First Baptist School will always be there in your life. As we saw you grow, and many of my colleagues have seen you from maybe from preschool, and we saw you grow, we saw you change, turn out now to be a young man, a young lady, we're glad. That has a tremendous impact on our life as we see you grow, as we see you advance, and we're going to see it more as you turn out to be a professional or you turn out to be the farm at home. As we see you, we will know that we had an input in who you are today. To the students of 10th grade, I want to say that the advancement of humanity is based on one generation advance upon where the previous generation lived in. You don't have to rewrite history right from the place where the previous generation lived. So 11th grade has reached to certain level. Now is your turn to write your history. You don't have to start from zero. We have something that has already been done. What we want you to do, take it from where they leave it. As they deliver the symbols to you in a sign of saying, okay, we are giving you the baton now so that you can advance. Take it from here and move it forward. I want to challenge you to take it from here. Take First Baptist School from where 11th grade is leaving it and move forward. Improve, do much more than what they did. But understand that you can learn from them, learn from the good things that they did, and learn also from their mistakes, so that you don't commit the mistakes. This institution is founded upon symbols. Symbols remind us of who we are. Symbols remind us what is our foundation. As a school, we have a heritage of Christianity, a heritage of language, a heritage of a community in which we live and for which we live. Therefore, I want to encourage all our students, let's be true and loyal to our institution. Let's respect our symbols, lift them up on high, that as you leave from this school, the things that were said today, then we will see it, and the community will see it in your life. So, God bless you. Let's keep on moving forward as we see 11th grade go and we see 8th grade move forward. 2 more years, it will be 9th grade, and then it will be 8th grade, and just like that, one day it will be 6th grade. It's a process. And as we move up to the forefront, we need to understand we are receiving a challenge. And that challenge is excellence. That challenge is to do the best that we can so that our institution will shine and be what all of us dream for it to be. God bless you. Thank you.
Muy bien, este ha sido el cierre. Termina la ceremonia de la entrega de símbolos. Solo presente le damos las gracias a los profesores que lideró esta ceremonia. Los dos bien recuerden, ellos son los que llevan la batuta. Ya nosotros nos retiramos, damos el cargo y esperamos que ustedes, eso es lo que decíamos, que ustedes lo hagan mejor que nosotros. Muchas gracias.